Hello, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, I'm Amwaki and welcome to Amwaki's vlog. When wanting to achieve our skincare routine goals, such as healthy skin and clearer skin, we are often too busy looking for products such as anti-acne products to include in our skincare routine that we forget about one of the basic essential products which our skin needs to maintain its healthy glow, the hydrating toner. In today's video, I'm going to talk about toners. Toners were previously called skin tonics. Common ingredients used to formulate skin tonics include glycerin, alcohol, witch hazel extract, tincture of benzoin, perfumed water, and colorants. But many formulations were mixtures of perfumed water, borax, and alcohol. They were formulated to soothe the nerves and take fatigue out of muscles. Because of the astringent property and the hydrating effect of some of the ingredients, skin tonics were frowned upon by most people. Modern day toners are more than just astringents and have numerous benefits for the skin. The difference between a toner and an astringent is a toner may or may not contain alcohol, but an astringent usually contains alcohol. An alcohol-free toner is mild on the skin. Astringents tend to make the skin feel dry instead of hydrated. When your skin is dehydrated, your moisture barrier is impaired. When your moisture barrier is impaired or damaged, there's increased rate of transepidermal water loss, which results in dry, rough, flaky skin, which is prone to acne and irritation. Your skin requires water to function properly. Hydration is key in helping our skin maintain that healthy glow. Astringents are usually used for insect bites, skin cuts, fungal infections, and minor skin irritations. Examples of astringents include witch hazel, alcohol, silver nitrate, and calamine lotion. So why do we need to use a toner? The skin's pH is about 4.5 to 5.5. The pH of the skin can be disrupted after cleansing due to the alkaline nature of soap. A deviation from the skin's pH could lead to the growth of harmful microorganisms and skin conditions. Toners restore the skin's pH balance. After cleansing, oil residue or dirt can be removed with a toner. Toners are great for prepping the skin before the application of other skincare products. They increase the penetration of skincare ingredients. They also keep the skin hydrated and maintain the skin's moisture. Honey, if your toner isn't doing any of these, then it's time to get yourself a new one, a hydrating toner. A toner is basically made up of water and humectants. Humectants are ingredients that hold on to water. They bind to water. Humectants contain a lot of hydroxy and oxygen groups. These groups can form hydrogen bonds with water molecules. Hydrogen bond is a very strong bond, so it's hard for water to evaporate when humectants bind to it. Examples of humectants are hyaluronic acid, glycerin, aloe extract, urea, and butylene glycol. The skin contains natural humectants known as natural moisturizing factor within the stratum corneum of the epidermis. They hydrate the stratum corneum. The skin's natural moisturizing factor consists of amino acids, lactic acid, minerals, sugars, sodium, urea, and peptides. We need skincare products like toners to help keep our skin hydrated because as we age, the level of humectants present in our skin decreases. Some toners contain chemical exfoliants as well. Examples of chemical exfoliants are alpha hydroxy acids, beta hydroxy acids, and polyhydroxy acids. Alpha hydroxy acids are suitable for normal to dry skin. Beta hydroxy acids are suitable for normal to oily skin. Avoid using toners that have high alcohol concentration. Traditionally, toners have the same viscosity as water, but nowadays, some toners are more viscous than water.
You can use cutting pads or your hands to apply a toner. I use rose water to tone my skin. When I use cutting pads, I put a few drops of the rose water toner on the cutting pads and I apply it onto my skin. If you're using a toner to remove residual dirt or makeup, it is best to use cotton pads. Rose water hydrates the skin, restores the skin's pH, has anti-inflammatory properties and antioxidants. When I use my hands, I put a few drops in my hands and I apply it all over my face and neck by patting it into my skin.
Comment below some of your favorite toners. Thank you so much for watching this video. Catch you in my next one. Bye!